Dear students, your attention is invited to lecture number 6 on the subject of atomic physics. The theme of lecture, solutions of time-independent Schrödinger equations. The simplest time-independent Schrödinger equation is the one for the case V function of x equals constant. A particle moving under the influence of such a potential is a free particle since of the force acting on it is F equals minus dV function of x over dx equals 0. As this is true regardless of the value of the constant, we do not lose generality by choosing the arbitrary additive constant that always arises in the definition of a potential energy in such a way as to obtain V function of x equals 0, formula number 1. We know that in classical mechanics, a free particle may be either at rest or moving with constant momentum p. In either case, its total energy E is a constant. To find the behavior predicted by quantum mechanics for a free particle, we solve the time-independent Schrödinger equation. Next formula. Setting V function of x equal 0. With this form for the potential, the equation is formula number 2. The solutions are the eigenfunctions psi function x of x and the wave functions psi function of x and t are formula number 3. The eigenvalues E are equal to the total energy of the particle. It is known that an acceptable solution of the time-independent Schrödinger equation for this non-bending potential should exist for any value of E greater than 0. Of course, we already know a form of the free particle wave function from our plausibility argument leading to the Schrödinger equation. That wave function is psi function of x and t equals cosine of k multiplied x minus omega multiplied t plus I multiplied sine of k multiplied x minus omega multiplied t. Rewriting it as a complex exponential, we have formula 4a. The wave number k and angular frequency omega are formula 4b. We break the exponential into the product of two factors. Next formula. Then we compare with the general form of wave function quoted in formula number 3. Next formula. This comparison makes it apparent that next formula 5. That is, the complex exponential of formula 5 gives the form of a free particle eigenfunction corresponding to the eigenvalue E. Most specifically, it is a traveling wave free particle eigenfunction because the corresponding wave function psi function from function of x and t equals e to I multiplied open round bracket k multiplied x minus omega multiplied t closed round brackets power represents to a traveling wave. This can be seen, for example, from the fact that the nodes of the real part of the oscillatory wave function are located at positions where k multiplied x minus omega multiplied t equals open round brackets n plus 1/2 closed round brackets multiplied p, with n equals zero plus minus and minus one plus and or minus two etc. The reason is that the real part of psi function of x and t, which is cosine of k multiplied x minus omega multiplied t, has a value zero, where k multiplied x minus omega multiplied t equals n plus 1/2 multiplied p. Thus, the nodes occur wherever x equals n plus 1/2 multiplied p divided k plus omega multiplied t divided k, and since these values of x increase with the increasing t, the nodes travel in the direction of increasing x. The conclusion is illustrated in the top part of figure 1, which shows plots on the real part of psi function of x and t at successively later times. For this wave function, the probability density psi asterisk function from function of x and t multiplied psi function of x and t, illustrated in the bottom of figure 1, conveys no sense of motion. Figure 1. Top and bottom figure. Intuition suggests that for the same value of E, there should also be a wave function representing a wave traveling in the direction of decreasing x. The preceding argument indicates that this wave function will be written with the sine of k multiplied x reversed, that is k. Formula number 6. The corresponding eigen function will be C function, formula number 7. It is easy to see that the eigen function is also a solution to the time-independent Schrödinger equation for V function of x equals 0. In fact, any arbitrary linear combination of the two eigen functions of formula 5 and 7 for the same value of the total energy E is also a solution to the equation. To prove these statements, we take the linear combination C function, formula number 8, in which A and B are arbitrary constants, and substitute it into the time-independent Schrödinger equations, formula number 2. Science. Next formula. Substitution into the equation yields. Formula. Since this is obviously satisfied, the linear combination is a valid solution to the time-independent Schrödinger equation. The general solution is useful because it allows us to describe any possible eigen function associated with the eigen value E. For instance, if we set B equals 0, we obtain the eigen function for a wave traveling in the direction of increasing x. If we set A equals 0, the wave is traveling in the direction of the decreasing x. If we set absolutely A equals absolutely B, there are two oppositely directed traveling waves that combine to form a standing wave. Standing wave eigen functions will be used later. Let us consider now that question of giving physical interpretation to the free particle eigen functions and wave functions. Take first the case of the wave traveling in the direction of the increasing x. The eigen function and wave function for this case are psi function from x and psi function from x of x and t, formula number 9. An obvious guess is that the particle whose motion is described by these functions is also traveling in the direction of increasing x. To verify this, let us calculate the expectation value of the momentum p for the particle. According to the general expectation value formula, psi, the main volume of the of a psi equals integral, where the operator for momentum is a psi p equals next formula. Now, for the wave function in question, we have next formula. So p, so the main volume of p equals next formula. The integral of the right is the probability density integrated of the entire range of the x-axis. This is just the probability that the particle will be found somewhere which must equal 1. Therefore, we obtain the main volume of p equals plus square root from 2 multiplied a multiplied e. This is exactly the momentum that we would expect for a particle moving in the direction of increasing x with total energy E in the region of zero potential energy. For the case of the wave traveling in the direction of decreasing x, the eigen function and the wave function are formula number 10. When we operate op c with p, the sign reversal of the k multiplied x term in the formula leads to a sign reversal in the result. This, in turn, leads to a momentum expectation value of next formula. The eigen function and wave functions just considered represent the idealized situation of a particle moving in one direction or the other in a beam of infinite length. Its x-coordinate is completely unknown because the amplitudes of the waves are the same in the all regions of the x-axis. That is, the probability densities, for instance, psi asterisk multiplied psi equals a asterisk multiplied a, are constants independent of x. The uncertainty principle states that in these situations we may know the value of the momentum p of the particle with complete precision, since delta p multiplied delta x greater than or equals h bar divided 2 can be satisfied for an uncertainty in the momentum of delta p equals 0 if delta x equals infinity. Perfectly precise values of the p are also indicated by the de Broglie relation p equals h bar multiplied k, because these wave functions contain only a single value of the wave number k. From the point of view of the target nucleus and the in terms of the distance of the order of its nuclear radius r prime, the x position of the proton in the beam may be for all practical purposes completely unknown. That is, delta x substituency greater than r prime. Thus, the free particle wave functions of formula 9 and 10 can give a good approximation to the description of the beam proton in the region of the interest near the nucleus, where the scattering takes place. In other words, near a nucleus, the wave function of formula number 9, psi function, can be used to describe a proton in the cyclotron beam directed towards increasing x, providing the beam is extremely long compared to the dimensions of the nucleus, a condition which is always satisfied in practice, since nuclei are extremely small. The wave function describes a particle moving with momentum precisely p equals h bar multiplied k and total energy precisely e equals h bar multiplied omega, where these quantities are related by the equation p, appropriate to a particle of mass m moving in the region of zero potential energy. There is a difficulty concerning the normalization of the wave functions of formula 9 and 10 in order to have, for instance, next formula. The amplitude A must be zero as integral from minus infinity to infinity dx has an infinite value. The proton beam is limited on one end by the cyclotron and on the other end by a laboratory wall. Also, the uncertainty delta x in location of the proton is very much larger than a nuclear radius r prime. It is not larger than the distance L from the cyclotron to the wall. That is, even so, delta x substantially bigger and greater than r prime, it is also true that the delta x less than L. This suggests that normalization can be obtained by setting psi equals 0 outside of the range. Next formula, or else by restricting x to be within the range. In either way, you obtain a more realistic description of the actual physical situation, and you can also normalize the wave function with a non-vanishing amplitude A. The procedure is called box normalization. Despite the fact that the value of A obtained depends on the length L of the box, it always turns out that the final result of calculation of a measurable quantity is independent of the actual value of L used. Figure 2 shows the probability density psi asterisk multiplied psi for a particularly simple group, its motion in the direction of increasing x, and the ever-increasing width of the group. At any instant, the location of the group can well characterized by the expectation value, the main value of x, calculated from the probability density. The constant velocity of the group d over dt of the main value of x equals the constant velocity of the free particle. V equals square root from 2 multiplied E divided M. Figure number 2, the probability density for the group traveling wave function of the free particle. Calculations starting from the Schrödinger equation led to an expression relating the change in the velocity dx over dt of the group of the change in the potential v function of x. The expression is next formula, where the bars denote expectation values of f function of x is the force corresponding to the potential v function of x. Thus, in the microscopic limit, we can ignore the bars representing expectation values or averages in the equations just displayed. We then conclude that Newton's law of motion can be derived from the Schrödinger equation in the classical limit of macroscopic systems. Newton's law of motion is a special case of Schrödinger's equation. Idealized potentials are used frequently in quantum mechanics to appropriate real situations because, being constant in each range, they are easy to treat mathematically. The results we obtain for these potentials will allow us to illustrate a number of characteristic quantum mechanical phenomena. An analogy is found in the procedure used as studying electromagnetism. This involves threading many idealized systems like the infinite wire, the capacitor without edge, etc. These systems are studied because they are relatively easy to handle, because they are excellent approximations to real ones, and because real systems are usually complicated to thread mathematically, which they have complicated geometries. The simplest case is the step potential illustrated in Figure 3. If you choose the origin of the x-axis to be at the step, and the arbitrary additive constant, what also occurs in the definition of a potential energy, so that the potential energy of the particle is zero when it is to the left of the step, v function of x can be written. Next formula, formula number 11, where v sub zero is the constant. We may think of v function of x as an approximate representation of the potential energy function for a charged particle moving along the axis of a system of two electrodes, separated by a very narrow gap, which are held at different voltage. Figure number 3. The upper half of figure 4 illustrates this system, and the lower half illustrates the corresponding potential energy function. As the gap decreases, the potential function approaches the idealization illustrated in figure 3. Assume that a particle of mass m and total energy E is in the region x less than 0 and that is moving towards the point x equals 0 at which the step potential V function of x abruptly changes its value. According to classical mechanics, the particle will move freely in that region until it reaches x equals 0, where it is subjected to an impulsive force F equals minus dV over dV function of x over dt acting in the direction of decreasing x. The idealized potential formula 11 yields an impulsive force of infinite magnitude acting only on a point x equals 0. However, as it acts on the particle only for an infinitesimal time, the quantity integral from integral f multiplied dt, the impulse, which determines the change in its momentum, is finite. Figure number 4, illustrating a physical system with a potential energy function that can be approximated by a step potential. The motion of the particle subsequent of the experiences, the force at x equals 0, depends in classical mechanics on the relation between E and V zeros. This is also true in quantum mechanics. In the present section, we treat this case where E less than V zeros, it is where the total energy is less than the height of the potential step, as illustrated in figure 5. Since the total energy E is a constant, classical mechanics says that the particle cannot enter the region x greater than 0. The reason is that in that region. Next formulas. Thus, the kinetic energy P squared divided 2 multiplied m would be negative in the region x greater than 0, which would lead to an imaginary value for the linear momentum P in the region. Neither is allowed or even makes physical sense in classical mechanics. Figure 5, the relation between total and potential energies for the particle incident upon a potential step with total energy less than the height of the step. According to the classical mechanics, the impulsive force will change the momentum of the particle in such a way that it will exactly reverse its motion, traveling off in the direction of the decreasing x with momentum in the direction opposite to its initial momentum. To determine the motion of the particle according to quantum mechanics, we must find the wave function, which is solution for the total energy E less than V zeros to the Schrödinger equation for the step potential of formula 11. Since this potential is independent of time, the actual problem is to solve the time-independent Schrödinger equation. From our quality discussion, we know that the acceptable solution should exist for any value of E greater than 0, since the potential cannot be the particle to a limited range of the x-axis. For the step potential, the x-axis breaks up into two regions. In the region where x less than 0 left of the step, we have V function of x equals 0. So the eigenfunction that will tell us about the behavior of the particle is the solution of the simple time-independent Schrödinger equation. Formula number 12. In the region where x bigger than 0, right of the step, we have v function of x equals v zeros. And the eigenfunction is the solution of the time-independent Schrödinger equation, which almost are simple. Formula 13. Consider the differential equation valued for the region of in which v function of x equals 0. Formula 12. Since this is precisely to the time-independent Schrödinger equation for a free particle, we take for its general solution the traveling wave eigenfunction of Formula 8. We write that eigenfunction as Formula 14. Next, consider the differential equation valid for the region in which v function of x equals v zeros, Formula 13. We do not expect an oscillatory function, such as in Formula 14, to be a solution, since the total energy E is less than the potential energy V zeros in the region of the interest. In fact, those considerations tell us that the solution will be a function which gradually approaches the x-axis. The simplest function with this property is the decreasing real exponential, which can be written. Formula 15. Let us find out if this solution, and if so, also find the required value of k second by substituting it into 13, which is supposed to satisfy. We first evaluated next formula. The substitution yields next formula. This satisfies the equation and therefore verifies the solution, providing formula 16. A clue to the form of another particle solution is found by noting that k second enters as a square in the equation preceding formula 16. Therefore, its sign is immaterial and the increasing exponential. Formula 17. Should also be a solution of the time-independent Schrödinger equation that we are dealing with. It is equally easy to verify this by substitution into the equation. But let us instead verify that the arbitrary combination of the two particular solutions. Formula 18. When there, where C and D are arbitrary constants in a solution to Formula 13. We calculate formula and substitute the result into the equation. We obtain next equation. Since 18 contains two arbitrary constants, it is a general solution of the time-independent Schrödinger equation for the region of the step potential where v function of x equals v zeros with e less than the v zeros. The arbitrary constants a, b, c, d, and d of formula 14 and 18 must be so chosen that the total eigenfunction satisfies the requirements concerning finiteness, single-valuedness, and continuity of c function of x and d function c of x over dx. Consider further the behavior of c function of x as x extends plus infinity. In this region of the x-axis, the general form of c function of x is given by 18 formulas. Inspection shows that it will generally increase without limit as x tends to plus infinity. Because of the presence of the first term, c multiplied e 2 minus k second multiplied x power, in the order to prevent this and keep c function of x finite, we must set the arbitrary coefficient c of the first term equals to 0. Thus we find c equals 0, formula 19. Single valuedness is satisfied automatically by these functions. To study their continuity, we consider the point x equals 0. At this point, the two forms of c function of x, given by 14 and 18 formulas must join in the such a way that the psi function of x and d psi function of x over dx are continuous. Continuity of psi function of x is obtained by satisfying the relation. Next formula, which comes from equating the two forms at e equals 0. The relation is d equals a plus b, formula 20. Continuity of the derivative of the two forms is obtained by equating these derivatives at x equals 0. Thus, we said, next equation, this yields formula 21. Adding formula 20 and formula 21 gives formula 22. Subtracting gives b equals formula 23. We have now determined a, b, and c in terms of d. Thus, the eigen function for the step potential and the for energy E less than V zeros is C function of x equals formula 24. The one remaining arbitrary constant d determines the amplitude of the eigen function, but it is not involved in any of its more important characteristics. The presence of this constant reflects the fact that the time-independent Schrödinger equation is linear in phi function of x, and so solutions of any amplitude are allowed by the equation. The wave function corresponding to the eigen function is psi function of x and t equals formula 25. Consider the region x less than 0. The first term in the wave function for this region is a traveling wave propagating in the direction of increasing x. This term describes a particle moving in the direction of increasing x. The second term in the wave function for x less than 0 is a traveling wave propagating in the direction of decreasing x, and it describes a particle moving in that direction. Obviously, r depends on the ratio b divide a, which specifies the amplitude of the reflect part of the wave function relative to the amplitude of the inciding part. But in quantum mechanics, probabilities depend on the intensities, such as b asterisk multiplied b and a asterisk multiplied a, not on amplitudes. Thus, we must evaluate r from the formula r equals b asterisk b divided a asterisk a, formula 26. That is, the reflection coefficient is equal to the ratio of the intensity of the part of the wave that describes the reflect particle to the intensity of the part that describes the incident particle. We obtain r equals formula 27. The fact that this ratio equals 1 means that a particle incident upon the potential step with total energy less than the height of the step has probability 1 of the being reflected. It is always reflected. This is agreement with the predictions of classical mechanics. Consider now the eigen function of formula 24, using the relation formula 28. It is easy to show that the eigen function can be expressed psi function of x, formula 29. If you generate the wave function by multiplying psi function of x by e to minus I multiplied e multiplied t divided x bar power, we see immediately that we actually have a standing wave because the locations of the modes do not change in time. In this problem, the incident and reflected traveling waves for x less than 0 combine to form a standing wave because they are of equal intensity. Figure 6 depicts this schematically. Figure 6 illustrating the combination of incident and reflected wave of equal intensities to form standing wave. In the top part of figure 7, we illustrate the wave function by plotting the eigen function formula 29, which is the real function of x if we take d real. The wave function can be thought of as oscillating in the time according to e to minus e I multiplied e multiplied t divided x bar power, with an amplitude to space dependence is given by psi function of x. Here we find a feature which is a sharp constant to the classical predictions. Also, in the region x greater than 0, the probability density psi asterisk psi formula 30, illustrated in the bottom of figure 7, decreases rapidly with increasing x. There is a finite probability of finding the particle in the region x greater than 0. Figure 7. In classical mechanics, it will be absolutely impossible to find the particle in the region x greater than 0, because their total energy is less than the potential energy. So the kinetic energy p squared divided 2 multiplied m is negative, and then momentum p is imaginary. Penetration does not mean that the particle is stored in the classical excluded region. Indeed, we have seen that the incident particle is definitely reflected from the step. Another point is the penetration of the excluded region, which obeys formula 30, is not to conflict with the experiments of classical mechanics. It is apparent from the equation that the probability of finding the particle with a coordinate x greater than 0 is only appreciable in a region starting at x equals 0 and extending in a penetration distance delta x, which equals 1 divided k second. The reason is that e 2 minus 2 multiplied k second multiplied x power goes very rapidly to 0 when x is very much larger than the 1 divided k second. Since k second equals square root from 2 multiplied m multiplied open round bracket v zeros minus e closed round brackets divided h bar, we have delta x equals. In the classical limit, the product of m and v zeros minus e is so large compared to h bar square that delta x is an imaginary. Next slide, you see applied literature, and next slide, questions to consolidate knowledge. Thank you for your attention.